మేబీ జూమ్ జూమ్ ది అన్మ్యూట్ చేయి, రెండు అన్మ్యూట్ చేయాలి.
And we'll be going live next 5 minutes.
Okay. The system says we are. Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Good afternoon, everyone. Now answer in the comments.
We will be going live in next 2 minutes.
Okay. Look at each other and mute and not just. Keep your video on. I do not keep you on.
We're good to go.
Wonderful afternoon to one and all, and welcome to Yashoda Hospitals Nursing Webinars every Thursday live on Facebook at 3 p.m. And today we have come up with the wonderful quiz on medical surgical nursing. That is also 17th Pro Quiz, International Pro Quiz. Now we have with us Ms. Srivani, who is a nursing educator at Yashoda Hospitals. She will make you to be even more energized during the Pro Quiz. Over to you, Srivani.
Please unmute yourself. Please unmute, Mr. Bani.
Very good afternoon, everyone. Myself, Srivani. Thank you, Yashoda, for giving me this opportunity. And I'm very happy to see people on the board, Ms. Rajni, Kavya, Swati, Rohini, Anusha, and waiting for more viewers. And those who are having Kahoot app, I request you to join with the game pin. And those who are coming on the live with the Facebook, I request you to answer on the comment session. And we are about to go. Welcome all the participants to the 17th Nursing Pro Online Quiz on the Medical Surgical Nursing. You can join on the game pin 1454403. And secrets to win the game. Eliminate the wrong answer first. Select the right option. Check for the multiple selects and double points. And the most vital and crucial thing is fastest finger wins. And we have four rounds. The first round is heat stroke and hyperthermia evaluation and its management. Round two, pediatric safety tips for summer season. Round three, emergency management for severe dehydration. Last but not least, round four, nursing perspective on inflammatory bowel disease, treatments, and best practices. And we are about to start round one. Round one is heat stroke and hyperthermia, its evaluation and management. Let's see what's the first question. The first question is, which of the below requires an immediate medical intervention? I repeat the question, which of the below requires an immediate medical intervention? Option A, heat stroke. Option B, heat exhaustion. Option C, both A and B. Option D, all the above. We have 29 who have answered, waiting for more, and time is up. And the right answer is heat stroke. Oh, we have only 9 who have answered the correct, expecting more right responses. And Lucky Swati. Lucky is on the top. Congratulations, Lucky. The second is Swati. The third is Haru, Deepika, and Rama. Let's see what is the rationale. Heat stroke is the right answer. It is a medical emergency requiring medical intervention, while heat exhaustion can manage with less intensive measure even in the home. Okay, then let's go to the next question. The next question is, the most crucial step in managing a patient with suspected heat stroke is, your options are, option A, administering antipyretics, option B, rapid cooling, option C, providing oral rehydration, option D, administering IV antibiotics. I repeat the question again, most crucial step in managing the heat stroke. Time's up. And the right answer is rapid cooling. I can see only 7 have answered the right question. And very good. Swati has come to the top. She has beaten Lucky. And then third is Haru, CH Deepika, and Rama. Now let's go to the second question. Sorry, the rationale is rapid cooling is an immediate management in the heat stroke as it prevents the organ damage. So keep cooling yourself. And this question is having double points. The question is, what is the common symptoms for discomfort heat stroke? from hyperthermia. And option A, profuse sweating, bradycardia. Option C, altered mental status. Option D, hypotension. We have 7 more seconds and only 21 have answered. Expecting for more responses. Very good. 34, 35. Time's up. The answer is altered mental status. Only 2 have answered correctly. Swati, great. You're still on leading. Rajni has come up. Lucky. What happened to you? Come up. Haru and Deepika. And the rational is identifying altered mental status as a key symptom for the heat stroke, which helps in detecting hyperthermia related conditions. And we are going to the next question. Round 2, pediatric safety tips for summer season. Okay, then let's see what's our first question. What is the most effective way to prevent dehydration in children during hot summer? Your first question is drinking water regularly. Second option, eating ice cream. Wow, I love ice cream. Option C, staying indoors. Option D, wearing light clothing. Okay, come on, waiting for your answers. 32, 33, time's up, guys. Wow, I can see a huge response. 28, drinking water regularly is the right answer. Swati, great going. Rajni, good. Lucky, keep it up. And answer is drinking water regularly. And it's very important to prevent dehydration in children during hot weather. So keep drinking more water and keep hydrating yourself. Let's go to the next question. Why is it important to supervise children around water bodies such as pool, lake, and beaches during summer? Option A, children can get sunburn easily. Option B, water activities are boring. Option C, the risk of drowning is very high. Option D, it helps children learn to swim faster. I love swimming. Do you love swimming? Time's up, guys. Yes, 12 have answered rightly. The risk of drowning is very high. Yes. Swati, keep it up. Good. You're good going. Rajni and Lucky. Yes. Deepika, come on. Come up. And your rational is? Yes, supervision is very important for the children's safety. Keep up that. The next question is, this is having double points. You can crack here. Most appropriate sunscreen recommendation for children to protect their skin from sunburn. Option A, SPF 15, reapply for every 4 hours. SPF 30, applied only once in a day. SPF 30, reapply every 2 hours. D, you don't need to apply any sunscreen. You have to just wear the hats. And let's see how many have answered correctly. 5. Okay, you can do good more. Try up for the next. And the rational is, okay, on the scoreboard, we have Rajni, Swati, Lucky. Good going. Please keep the same. And let's see what is the rational. Yes, SPF 30, if you apply it every second hourly, it prevents the skin burn and also it protects our skin. And let's see what is our second question. Next question. Round 3. Emergency management in severe dehydration. Okay, we all get dehydrated in the summer, yes? So let's see what is there. First priority in emergency management of patient with severe dehydration. What are the options? Option A, oral rehydration therapy. B, intravenous fluid therapy. C, providing high calorie food. D, taking a detailed medical history. What would help us to keep more rehydrated? Okay, got 34 responses, 35 times up, guys. 19 have answered correctly. Good, expecting more right answers. Wow, Swati has come up. Rajni, good. Ishu, wow, she has come onto the board. CH Deepika and Haru. Deepika, please come up. And let's see what's the rational. Okay. Initiating intravenous fluid therapy. Okay, this will help us to prevent shock, which avoids medical emergency. Carry your bottles with you. Keep rehydrating yourself. And let's see what the next question is. Okay, which of the following sign is a key indicator of severe dehydration in adults? Okay, mild thrust, option A. Option B, dry mouth. Option C, decreased skin turgor. Rapid pulse. Option D, slightly concentrated urine. Okay, time's going. Expecting more answers. 3, 2, 1, 0. Time's up. Okay, 21 have answered correctly. Great going, guys. Okay, let's see what's the rational. Swati, great. You're coming up. Rajni, Ishu, Deepika, and Haru, good. Let's see what's the rational. Identifying decreased skin turgor and rapid pulse is an indicator of severe dehydration. So keep and check on your skin, okay? And let's see what the next question is. Round 4. Nursing perspective on inflammatory bowel disease. Let's see its treatment and best practices. And what's the first question? What is an initial treatment plan in severe dehydration? Okay. And administrating antipyretics, addressing electrolyte imbalances, encouraging bed rest, providing high protein diet. Which would you prefer, guys? Okay, 25 have answered. More answers. Time's up. Okay, all the 24 have answered correctly. Let's see who is on the board. Swati, great. Yes, you're on the board. Okay, the rational is, it is an alongside fluid replacement in a management of severe dehydration. So you have to first address the electrolyte imbalances. Okay, let's see what's the next question. Which of the following is a common symptom of IBD, inflammatory bowel disease? Option A, weight gain. Option B, chronic diarrhea. Option C, skin rash. And option D, joint pain. What do you think is the right answer? 24, 25, 28. Yes, great going. And time's up. 0. Okay, great. 32 have answered right. Okay, let's see who is on board now. Great, Swati, Rajni, Ishu, Deepika, Haru. Great, guys. Yes, chronic diarrhea is a hallmark symptom of IBD. So you have to take in medical attention very immediately. Let's see what the next question is. Okay, what is a primary goal in management of patient with IBD during flare-up? Okay, your option 1, increasing dietary fiber. Option B, reducing inflammation. Option C, promoting physical activity. Option D, enhancing protein intake. So, what might be the reason of flare-up, guys? Yes, 31 have answered. 34, time's up. Yes, 23 right answers we have got. Swati, still on the top. Great going. Rajni, Ishu. And the rational is, reducing inflammation as a primary goal is managing IBD flare-ups. Okay, whatever the inflammation is there, you have to immediately seek and medical attention. Let's see what's our next question. Okay, this is the last question and it is the last one. You have chance. Which diagnostics test is commonly used to confirm diagnosis in IBD? ECG, which is nothing but electrocardiogram, colonoscopy, chest x-ray, blood glucose test. Last question, guys. It's having 2 points. Fastest finger wins. And 2, 1, time up. Oh, wow. Great. 39. All the 39 have answered right. Let's see the rational. Huh? Who is on the board? Okay, we'll see the rational. The role of colonoscopy is a key diagnostic tool to identify inflammatory bowel disease because it will help us to visualize intestinal inflammation. It gives you an accurate diagnosis. Okay. Congratulations to the winners. Join us every Thursday. Facebook Live at 3 p.m. for more and more exciting webinars and quiz. Take a selfie with your quiz group. Hashtag Yashoda Hospital Nursing Education and Training Webinars on your social media. Keep it more interesting, guys. And let's see who is the winner on the podium. And who stood third? Ishu, you stood third. Great. Rajni, yes, you stood second. Who is on the top? Swati, congratulations, and congratulations to the all the runner-ups, Deepika and Subha. Great going, guys. Congratulations again.
Thank you so much, Shrivani. That was so wonderful. So as I can understand that this was so quick, but still, please join us every Thursday at 3 p.m. on Facebook Live every Thursday. Thank you, everyone.